This video we are going to talk about tinnitus or ringing in the ear. So if you have this condition that is persistent, go and visit your ENT doctor. So this condition can either be caused due to earwax or certain medical conditions like Meniere's disease or after head injury or nervous system problem like multiple sclerosis, or it could be noise induced tinnitus, or it could be side effects of certain medications like antibiotics, loop diuretics, painkillers. But there are a lot of cases where you cannot find the exact reason, the cause. And that is where nutritional approach is very, very important, because this approach is often ignored in the treatment of tinnitus. So if you have tinnitus, especially sound induced tinnitus, what happens that there is cochlea, which is the part of your inner ear, and it looks like the shell of snail. So those people who have tinnitus, especially sound induced tinnitus, they have decreased level of copper zinc superoxide dismutase. So this superoxide dismutase is your body's antioxidant, and this is very, very important to fight against free radical damage. So the first thing that you have to do is eat a healthy diet that is rich in copper and zinc. And in a small clinical trial, zinc supplementation has improved this condition. So zinc. Then next thing you want to do is to increase the blood flow to the cochlea, and there is the artery, that is spiral modular artery, SMA. So to increase the blood flow, one of the important vitamins that you need is B3, that is niacin. So this is very, very important. Then there is role of nervous system. So in tinnitus, what happens that there is some problem with the conducting pathway, especially in the cranial nerves. So one important vitamin that will improve this condition, that is very, very important for your nervous system, is vitamin B12. And then what you have to focus is to recover from the damage. So to recover from the damage, you need to eat high quality protein. So protein is very, very important. And other things like healthy lifestyle, managing stress, you will see remarkable benefit. And to improve circulation, some people have benefited by taking supplement that is ginkgo biloba. So this also improves circulation inside your inner ear and can help you in this zinc supplement at least 50 mg per day, along with eating copper rich foods like green leafy vegetables, cereals, meat, liver, etc. Fifth important thing is calcium deposits can also cause ringing in the ear. So calcium deposits inside the cochlea can also cause ringing in the ear. So do not take a calcium supplement unless you have a documented deficiency of calcium. And to decrease the calcification, you can benefit by taking K2 supplement as well as eating a lot of vegetables, because vegetables are rich in phytin, and phytin help you to get rid of excess calcium. So I would say do these things along with managing stress, getting high quality sleep, exercising, eating healthy diet, and you will see that this condition will slowly go away. Thank you.